हिरण्मये नपत्रेण सत्यस्यापि हितं मुखं तत्त्वं कोशनपाब्रणो सत्यधर्माय द्रोष्टये। आई वेलकम एवरीबडी टू द स्वाध्याय ज्ञान यज्ञ प्रोग्राम बाय एकेडमी ऑफ योगा एंड ओरिएंटल स्टडीज भुवनेश्वर। दिस इज ए लेक्चर सीरीज ऑन हठ योग प्रदीपिका बाय डॉक्टर इंदुलता दास, डायरेक्टर एकेडमी ऑफ योगा एंड ओरिएंटल स्टडीज। This is the 8th lecture of Hatha Yoga Pradipika, Chapter 3. Today we'll discuss on Jalandhara Bandha. Now, what is yoga? The word yoga is derived from the root yuj samadho. Yuj ghae yoga. So yoga is samadhi. Vyasa also says yoga samadhi. It is the state where the vritti sapti mind are absolutely checked. Yoga chitta vritti nirodha. This is yoga sutra. Yoga or samadhi is attained only when the mind is absolutely conquered by the yogi. Therefore, yoga is the science of conquering the mind. Now, what is hatha yoga? What hatha means forceful or exertion of force. Amar Kosha says prasabhantu balatkara hatha. The word hatha means forceful or exertion of force. Do something by using force. Hatha yoga is that branch of yoga which attaches importance on exerting force. A frequently asked questions. Does ha mean sun and tha mean moon? And therefore, hatha yoga means the union of sun and moon. Answers are many. Number one, this is absolutely wrong notion. In no authentic Sanskrit dictionary or thesaurus, ha and tha are found as synonyms of sun and moon. Number two, Hatha Yoga Pradipika, the greatest book of Hatha Yoga, or even the Gheranda Sanghita, does not mention the theory of union of sun and moon. Number three, answer. Among the nadis, Sushumna is the most important nadi. It is the one which leads to liberation. In Katha Upanishad we find Satam Chaikacha Hudayasa Nadya Stasang Muddhanam Abhinishriteka Tayordhamaya Natimrutyu Meti Vishwang Anya Utramane Bhavanti. That means there are 101 nadis in the heart. Only one nadi, that is Sushumna, moves to the crown of the head. The aspirant gets liberated when he comes through this nadi. All the other nadis are meant for death. Now, rightly, Hatha Yoga focuses on Sushumna because it leads to liberation. Ida and Pingala are like many other nadis. So, why should a complete branch of yoga, that is Hatha Yoga, be named after the nadis which cannot give liberation? Now, we come to mudra in Hatha Yoga. Mudras are specific yogic postures usually associated with specific regulation of breath. Their number is 10. According to Hatha Yoga Pradipika, their number is 25 according to Gheranda Sanghita. Both mudras and bandhas are included in the class of mudra. Now, necessity of mudra. Mudras are mainly practiced to arouse kundalini. Tasma sarva prajatrena prabodhayitum ishwaring brahmadvara mukhe suptang mudra bhyasam samacharet. One should practice mudras in order to awaken goddess kundalini who is lying latent on the brahmadvara or at the gate of Sushumna. Now we come to Jalandhara Bandha. It is the 7th mudra in sequence in Hatha Yoga Pradipika. It is a very important mudra. Now the name, whether it is Jalandhara Bandha or Jalandhara Bandha. In Hatha Yoga Pradipika we find the name Jalandhara. Uddiyanam Mulabandha Satha Jalandhara Abhitaha. And in some other books like Gheranda Sanghita we find the name Jalandhara Bandha. Mahamudra Nabha Mudra Uddiyanam Jalandharam. In the same book, that means in Gheranda Sanghita again, the word Jalandhara is also used. So which one is correct? Now why Jalandhara? Because it blocks the flow of water which flows from the palate. Adhogami Nabha Jalam. Therefore it is called Jalandhara Bandha. Jalandhara Titi Jalandhara. Now why Jalandhara? It obstructs the net of blood vessels or nadis, Sira Jalam, Jalandhara Bandha. So it is called Jalandhara Bandha. Jalandhara Titi, Jalandharaha. Both are correct. So both the names are correct. Now, the clarification about the Nabhojala and the Sirajala. Badhnatihi Sirajalam Adhogami Nabhojalam Tato Jalandharo Bandhaha. This bandha obstructs all the nadis passing through the neck. It also obstructs the downward movement, moving flow of liquid which oozes from the sky or upper region of the body, that is palate. Therefore, it is called Jalandhara Bandha. So, that is a clarification given in Hatha Yoga Pradipika. Now, technique of Jalandhara Bandha. Bandha makuncha hrudaya sthapaya jivkan gruhan. Bandha Jalandhara kyoya. The yogi should contract the throat and press the chin against the chest very strongly. This is the technique of Jalandhara Bandha. Now, importance of this bandha because it is done in an important place. The place is Vishuddhi Chakra. Madhya Chakra Midang Praktam Sodasadhara Lakhanam Hatha Yoga Pradipika says. The place is called Madhya Chakra, Vishuddha Chakra or Vishuddhi Chakra, characterized by 16 supports, 16 spokes, 16 supports. Sodasadhara Lakhanam. Now what is Sodasadhara? 16 yoga nadis emanate from this place or in Vishuddhi Chakra and resemble 16 petals of a lotus or 16 spokes of a wheel. The vibrations produced from the nadis resemble the sounds of 16 letters. These letters are O, A, I, E, U, U, Ri, Ri, Li, Ri, A, I, O, O, Ang, and Aha. In Shiva Sangita, we find the description, Suhe Mahabhang Saropetang Sodasa Swara Sanjutang. These 16 spokes with 16 sounds in them are the characteristic feature of this chakra. Therefore, it is called Sodasadhara Lakshanam. Now, spokes are the supports, Adhara of a wheel. Without spokes, wheel cannot remain. These 16 spokes are the supports of the wheel of Vishuddhi Chakra. Therefore, it is called Sodasadhara Lakshanam here. Now, there is a secondary interpretation of the word Sodasadhara. See, 16 places of meditation. Now, let us discuss this. The 16 Adharas we find in Siddha Siddhanta Paddhati. Number one Adhara is Padangushtadhara. Tatra Prathamang Padangushtadharam Tatra Gatas Tejo Mayang Dhyaya Drushtihi Sthira Bhavati. The big toes meditate on light, eyesight becomes steady. Second is Muladhara. Dityang Muladharam Sutram Vama Parsina Nipidya Statabhyang Tad Agna Tatragni Dipanang Bhavati. Here it is Muladhara, press it by left heel, the digestive fire will increase. Then third is Gudadhara. Trutiyam Gudadharam, Vikasa Sankacham, Nirakunchay, Tapana Vayu, Sthiro Bhavati. This is anus, stop on contraction and expansion, apana air becomes titi. Then there is the Medhradhara. Chaturthang Medhradharam, Linga Sankachanena, Brahma Granthi Trayang Bhitva, Brahma, Brahmara Guhayang Vishramya, Tata Urdhamukhe Bindu Stambhanam Bhavati. Esa Vajrali Prasiddha. This is penis. By contracting it, the sex fluid does not fall. It is also famous as Vajrali. Then there is Swadhisthana. Panchama Uddayana Dharayoha Vardhana Malamutra Sankochanam Bhavati. Swadhisthana, also known as Uddayana Pitha. If one meditates here, then quantity of stool and urine diminishes. Then sixth is Nabhyadhara, Sashte Nabhyadhare Omkaram Eka Chittena Uccharite Nadalaya Bhavati. It is navel uttering Omkara with concentration, one merges in Nada. Then there is Hrudayadhara, Saptame Hrudayadhare Pranam Nirodhayat Kamala Vikaso Bhavati. It is heart. By retaining prana in heart, the lotus blooms. Then there is Kanthadhara. Ashtame Kanthadhare Kanthamulam Chibukena Nirodhayat Hidapingloyer Bayuhus Thiro Bhavati. It is neck, press the neck by chin, air in Ida and Pingala will be held. Then there is Ghantikadhara, Navame Ghantikadhara Jivagram Dharayat Amruta Kalas Sravati. Root of tongue, press the tongue at the root of tongue, the nectar flows. Then there is Taluadhara, Dasame Taluadhare Talvantar Garbhe Lambikang Chalana Dohanabhyang Dirghikrutva Viparitena Praveshayat Kasti Bhavati. Palate. This is palate. Insert the elongated tongue into the palate. one becomes motionless. Then 11th is Juhadhara, Ekadasam Atha Juhadharam Tatra Juhagram Dharay Sarva Roga Naso Bhavati. It is tongue, meditate on the tip of tongue, diseases are cured. Then there is Bhrumadhyadhara, Dvadasam Bhrumadhyadharam Tatra Chandra Mandalam Dhyay Sitalatang Jati. Middle of eyebrows, meditate on lunar cycle, one becomes cool. Then Nasadhara, Trayodasam Nasadharam Tasyagram Lakhet Manahasthiram Bhavati. This is nose, meditate on tip of it, mind becomes concentrated. Then there is Nasamulam, Chaturdase Nasamulam, Kavatadharam, Tatra Dushting Dhare, Sarmasa Jyoti Punjang Pashyati. This is root of nose, by gazing on it, one sees mass of light in 6 months. Then there is Lalatadhara, Panchadase Lalatadharam, Tatra Jyoti Punjang Lakhe, Tejasri Bhavati. This is forehead, meditate on mass of light in the forehead, one becomes brilliant. Then 16th is Avasishte Brahma Randham Akasa Chakram Tatra Sri Guru Charanambuja Jugman Sada Avalokay Akasavat Punno Bhavati. This is Brahma Randra. Meditate lotus feet of Guru in Brahma Randra. One becomes full like the sky. This is Siddha Siddhanta Padrati, second chapter. However, the first interpretation of the 16 spokes as Sodasadhara is most appropriate. Now, this is Jalandhara Bandha being performed by Sunil Kumar Devata. Now, benefits of Jalandhara Bandha. Number one, two nadis are blocked. Kantha sankha chanayanaiva dve nadya stambayet drudham. By contraction of throat, two nadis, Ida and Pingala, are contracted. Then air enters into Sushumna naturally. It is the aim of mudras, to make the air flow through Sushumna and make Kundalini move through it. Number two benefit, nectar is not destroyed. Jalandhare krute bandhe kantha sankocha lakhyane na piyusam patatyatho. When Jalandhara bandha is done, the throat is contracted, bodily nectar does not flow down. As a result, relief from old age and death. There is relief from old age and death. Jara mrityu vinasaka, says Hatha Yoga Pradipika. It is destroyer of old age and death. Jalandhara bandha destroys old age and death. Now, about old age and death, we find mentions in various texts. Let us see in Upanishad. Na tasya roga na jara na mrityu praktasya yogagni mayam sariram. This is Sweta Sutra Upanishad. The yogi whose body is burnt by the fire of yoga does not suffer from disease, old age and death. Now again mention in other text, maranam tasya king devi prucha sindhu sana samanane naso maranam apnoti punar yoga balenatu. This is yoga bijam. It is said the yogi does not die because of yoga. Because he practices yoga, therefore he doesn't die. Yogi is liberated. He doesn't die. He is not dead. He does not die to be born again. He discards the physical body at the end. He discards his physical body and never to come back again. So this is not death. This is liberation. He is liberated. He is not dead. Then, what is the cause of old age and death? It is the nectar, sun and moon. We have to discuss about the nectar, sun and moon here. Moon is situated above the palate. Nectar oozes from moon. It flows gradually to the sun, which is at the navel, and is destroyed there. Human cells decay and die because of this process. Old age and death are ultimate results of this wastage. Now, there is description of old age in Hatha Yoga Pradipika. Jatkinchit sravate chandra tamrutam divyarupinaha tas sarvam grasate suryas tena pindo jarayutaha. Whatever nectar the divine moon secretes, it is devoured by the sun. As a result, the body becomes old. Now, description in Hatha Yoga Pradipika about death. Chandra sara sravati papushas tena mrityur narana. From the moon, the essence of the human body flows. Man dies because of this loss. Now, exact location of moon and sun. This is Gorakhya Satakam. We find the exact location in Gorakhya Satakam very nicely. नाभिदेशे स्थितो नित्यं भास्करो दहनात्मकः अमृतात्मा स्थितो नित्यं तालु मूले और तालु मध्ये च चंद्रमः वर्षत्यधो मुखश्चंद्रो ग्रसत्युद्ध मुखो रविः. दिस इज गोरख्य शतकम. द बर्निंग सन इज एट द नाभिल. द मून विच इज फुल ऑफ नेक्टर इज एट द रूट ऑफ द पैलेट. द मून हुज फेस इज डाउनवर्ड सीक्रेट्स द नेक्टर. द सन हुज फेस इज अपवर्ड डिवोर्स इट. सो प्रैक्टिस ऑफ जालंधर बंध blocks the way of the nectar from going downward and being wasted. Therefore, there is no old age and death. Now, the air is not vitiated. Vayu or vata is not vitiated. This is another benefit of Jalandhara Bandha. Nacha vayu prakupyati. Practice of Jalandhara Bandha checks the vitiation of vata, vayu prakopana. What is vata and what is vishesan of vata? Three dosas in the body, vata, pitta and kapha. There are three dosas in our body. These are vata, pitta and kapha. These are responsible for the wellness as well as illness of the body. In Ashtanga Hrudaya we find vayu pittam kapha cheti trayo dosah samasata vikruta vikruta deham granti te vartayanti cha. The three dosas, vayu, pitta and kapha, keep the body well when normal and make the body ill when they are vitiated. Now what happens when dosas are vitiated? Vata when vitiated, it causes 80 diseases. Kapha when vitiated causes 20 diseases. Pitta when vitiated causes 40 diseases. In Charaka Sangita we find tajyatha asitir vata vikaraha chattvarinsat pitta vikaraha vinsati hi shleshma vikaraha. By the practice of Jalandhara Bandha, one is safe from the 80 kinds of diseases caused by vata. Now, the next benefit, it removes all types of diseases of the throat. Kantha Dukho Ghanasana, Hatha Yoga Pradipika. All diseases of the throat are removed by Jalandhara Bandha. Now, what are the throat diseases? These are 18 in numbers. We find in Bhava Prakasa, रोहिणी पंचदा प्रोक्ता कंठ सालुक्य एवच अधिजिह्वश्च बलयो बलासश्चैक वृंदक ततो वृंद शतघ्नी च विलायुः कंठ विद्रथिः गलौघश्च स्वरघ्नश्च मांसतानस्तथैव च विदारी कंठ देशे तु रोगा अष्टादश स्मृताः. नाउ देयर आर फाइव काइंड्स ऑफ रोहिणी वातज पित्तज एटसेट्रा. And there is Kantha Salukya, Adhijiva, Balaya, Balasa, Ekabrundaka, Brunda, Satagni, Gilayu, Kantha Vidradhi, Galauha, Swaragna, Mangsatana, Vidari. These are the 18 diseases of the Kantha or throat. Practice of Jalandhara Bandha prevents and relieves these 18 problems of the throat. Kantha Dukho Ghanasana. Now, there is advice to practice another two bandhas simultaneously with Jalandhara Bandha. The author of Hatha Yoga Pradipika, Swami Swatmarama, he advises the practitioner to practice another two bandhas simultaneously with Jalandhara Bandha in order to get maximum benefit. So what are these bandhas? He writes, Mulasthanam samakunche uddiyanam tu karet idancha pingalang badhva bahayet paschime pathi. The practitioner should contract the anus. That means he should assume Mula Bandha. Then do Uddiyana Bandha. Then he should block the Ida and Pingala by Jalandhara Bandha. Prana would flow through the back way or through the Susumna Nadi. This is written in Hatha Yoga Pradipika. Then the air certainly enters into the Susumna. Again he writes, Ananaiva Vidhanena Prajati Pavana Layam ततो न जायते मृत्युर जरा रोगादिकं तथा. By this method the prana air merges into the brahmarandhra, then death and old age etc. do not occur in the body of the practitioner. So one should practice the three bandhas together. Now the greatness of the three bandhas if they are practiced together. Bandhatrayamidam sreshtam mahasiddhescha sevitam sarvesam hatha tantranam sadhanam yogino viduh. This triad of bandhas is the most important and is practiced by great siddhas. It is this triad is recognized by yogis to be the most important means in all Hatha yogi systems. Now, like this, Jalandhara Bandha is a very important practice of Hatha Yoga. I thank you. If you have any question, you may write in the comment box. I shall be happy to answer your questions. If you want to see our other lectures, then this is the link for it.